أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Occam's razor, also known as the law of parsimony. It is the problem-solving principle that states that entities should not be multiplied without necessity. The idea is attributed to the English Franciscan friar William O. Occam, who lived between 1287 and 1347, a scholastic philosopher and theologian, who used a preference for simplicity to defend the idea of divine miracles. It is sometimes paraphrased by a statement like, "The simplest solution is most likely the right one." So let us do an exercise. Where we compare, without mentioning any names, the 4,200 religions on planet Earth, as you Google it, gives you that number. And according to David Humes, who is an atheist, that all of it are human product. 4,000 years, trying to answer many questions and to calm down their anxiety and fears. So let us assume this is what it is and find out the simplest solution, which is the most likely is the right one. Let us look for a religion which is so simplistic, without compromising its values and authenticity, aesthetic, with delicious fruits. So, of course, I'm not going to mention the 4,200 religions, but I'm going to mention Islam. The concept of God, very, very simple. God is one, creator of everything. The first man, Adam, the cognitive man, existed for the last 200,000 years on planet Earth. He made a mistake, he apologized, and he asked forgiveness, and he was forgiven. As simple as that. The newborn from all races are beautiful, innocent, natural, and debt-free. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the perfect man, is a human, fully human. Revelation came unto him. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. Islam, from far, everyone, from the Arab, those are the genuine, simple, raw, non-corrupted, with civility and cities, whenever they hear the message of Islam, their natural response, ما أجمل هذا الدين وأحسن. How beautiful this religion and how good it is. Muhammad Asad, in previous sessions, I mentioned his description to this beautiful structure of Islam. It enjoins everything good. يحسن الحسن. And forbid everything evil. ويقبح القبيح. In this study of this religion, and this is the most beautiful of everything, no middlemen. So, I know a lot of jobs are lost. No middlemen, no religious men. All of us are human, and all of us have our faults and shortcomings and sins. So the relation between you and your Creator is so simple. He's so close to you, closer than your jugular vein. And all what you have to do, just say, oh God. And then ask Him anything you want in the darkness of night, any time of the day, any place in the world. The problem with the religious, quote-unquote, religious people and the organized religion created one of the three tyrannies which clogged the human mind. The tyranny of despotic rulers, the tyranny of the organized religion, and the tyranny of the ancestors. And their bad practices. So we don't have to tell what the middlemen have been doing, claiming they are managing your soul. Nobody's managed your soul but you, with direct relation with God, with serious repentance and trying to stand up and try to do the good thing again. We know from many other disciplines that when you draw a rectangle, like a basketball field, and put some rules, you create an empire with billions and billions of dollars. And this is what happened in many of the religions. From the original sin to the middlemen who manage the soul, and all what follows created big business. Trillions of dollars belongs to all some of those great establishments. The holy book is Al-Quran. We talked about it yesterday. It's so beautiful, so eloquent. It can take your heart and mind forever. And let us hear the testimony of one of the non-believers, Al-Walid ibn Al-Mughira Al-Makhzumi. And he is the father of Khalid ibn al-Walid, radiallahu anhu. When he heard the Quran and continued to, at night, visit the neighborhood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to listen to his recitation, then he was caught by Abu Jahl, and he rebuked him and told him, you are going to make fitna among the people and create troubles. And when he asked him, what is this? What is he saying? He said, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا فِيكُم مِّن رَجُلٍ أَعْلَمُ بِالْأَشْعَارِ مِنِّي. He swore to those people who met him in the neighborhood, said, nobody knows poetry more than me. ولا أعلم برجزه ولا بقصيده ولا بأشعار الجن مني والله والله ما يشبه الذي يقول شيئا من هذا. All the discipline of language and poetry and prose and everything, nothing look like what he is saying. إن لقوله لحلاوة, so sweet. وإن عليه لطلاوة, so bright. وإنه لمثمر أعلاه, it's fruitful on the top. مغدق أسفله, rich from the bottom. وإنه ليعلو وما يعلى عليه, وإنه ليحطم ما تحته. I hope that we will sit down and study this beautiful religion of Islam, the religion of justice, the religion of peace, the religion of love, mercy, and compassion, and sympathy, and empathy. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum.